Hello everyone, this is Deborah Richardson, and today I am putting the AP in Happy, where accounts payable teams are empowered to protect the vendor master file from fraud. This podcast will give a voice to accounts payable team members by talking about the growing reality of cyber attacks in their world and which vendor setup and vendor management techniques they can apply to protect the vendor master file from fraud. If you are looking for vendor process training for you or your entire vendor team, head over to my site at deborahrrichardson.com and click on the Vendor Team Training Solved button to learn more about what is included in the monthly or annual plan and also to download a 2021 training schedule. Get the training that you and your team needs to avoid payment fraud, duplicate vendors, compliance fines, and more. Did you know there are accounts payable or AP organizations that have AP celebration weeks? Well, we're going to talk about three organizations today, and with one of their celebration weeks coming up in May, and actually it's coming up in 2 weeks. Let's get started. Keep listening. Welcome to episode 134. Don't miss these 2021 opportunities to celebrate with your AP team. After the year most of us in accounts payable or AP world have had, and after recognizing that it's still not over as we continue into 2021, you may be ready to take advantage of all opportunities to celebrate with your team this year. And with that said, let's talk about the organizations or three organizations and their celebration weeks that you have to look forward to as they start to get underway for the year. Okay, so let's talk about AP organizations and their celebration weeks. Now, these AP organizations celebrate at different times during the year. And where the date has been published, I will note that, but not all of the three have published their 2021 weeks yet, but you can keep checking the link that I'll put in the show notes. It will link back to the blog for this podcast, and you'll be able to link back to the events so that you can check to see if they're updated. You can check their websites, because I have the link to that, to see when they're when they've been updated, or I'll also have a link to an AP event that has all of the events included, and that I will keep updated. So you'll have a couple different places you can check to see when, and out of the two or out of the three, two of them have publisher weeks and one hasn't. So you only have to keep up with one. Okay, so here they are in the order of when they are scheduled for the year or when they are expected to be scheduled in 2021. And I base that on the week that they celebrated in 2020. So the first one is the Accounts Payable Association for the UK. Now, the AP Association is the UK's most trusted provider of award-winning AP resources, events, and certification programs. Now, I took that right off of their homepage. And for 3 years, they have celebrated with an AP Appreciation Week, and is the only one of the included organizations in this podcast episode to also have daily panel discussions, vendor demos, etc. throughout the week. So you want to make sure you click on the link to get to their page to see everything that's included. And I remember the first year I participated, I think it was their first AP Appreciation Week back in 2019. I could be mistaken, but I think it was, I actually participated and baked a cake. So I baked a cake. So you guys don't know this, but I don't bake and I don't bake cakes, but I baked a cake. And I think the theme of the day was like AP Ninja. And so I got a Ninja Turtle and I put it on top of the cake and took a picture, and the picture got included in a bunch of stuff. So it was a lot of fun. So my point was, is that it's a lot of fun. AP team members enjoy it, and they even pulled me in to bake. Just saying. All right, so they're the only ones, right, to have all these things going on each day, so make sure you check it. They have a different theme each day, and they also have a wall of appreciation, which is great to use to recognize a team member, you know, for doing something great. And the way that you do that is you will post on social media, and I've seen a lot of LinkedIn, what are those called, appreciation posts or recognition post. And what you can do then is use the hashtag APA week 2021, and that hashtag will be in the blog post, so make sure you check the show notes. But if you use that hashtag with your LinkedIn recognition post or your Twitter post or Instagram, wherever you put it, use that hashtag, and then that post will be pulled in to appear on the wall of appreciation. So it's really cool. Now this one, it's the AP Appreciation Week is held every year. The last 2 years it's been in May. I actually think the first year was in May too, but I don't remember. That might've been April. But this year is going to be May 17th to the 21st. So whenever you're listening to this podcast, it will be published on Thursday, May 6th. So from the day that it's published, you've got 11 calendar days to learn all about it and identify, you know, how you guys are going to celebrate, what you're going to sign up for the week. Because like I said, they do have lots of events that are scheduled. Now, it is free, and I will have the link to the APA Appreciation Week page that will be in the blog post. And again, the link for the blog post will be in the show notes. All right, so the next one is the Institute of Finance and Management, or IOFM. And this is actually the one that I am most familiar with, because up through the years, this is the one that I used to participate with. And so if you don't know what the Institute of Finance and Management, or IOFM, is, I believe they've been around since 1982. They used to be the old Accounts Payable Network, or TAPN, because that's what I originally signed up under. And then they changed their name to Institute of Finance and Management, or IOFM. But anyway, their mission is to align the resources, events, education, and networking opportunities they offer with what companies need from the accounting and finance functions. Now, while they have the AP certifications, they've got the Accounts Payable Specialist, or APS, and the Accounts Payable Manager, or APM, AP certifications. They also serve accounting and accounts receivable, or AR, professionals, and so they have certifications for them as well. And so last year, they really reflected that combination in the name of their appreciation week, which was Financial and Accounting Appreciation Week. And so that appreciation week is typically held in September or October of every year. Up through the years, I remember it used to be in October. For the past couple of years, it's been in September. This year, it is going to be September 20th through the 24th. So again, September 20th to the 24th, and there is a free sign up, and I will put that in the blog post that will be linked in the show notes. Now, the next one, the third organization, is the Institute of Financial Operations, or IFO. Now, this institute grew out of the merger of four different associations: the International Accounts Payable Professionals, IAPP, the International Accounts Receivable Professionals, IARP, the National Association of Purchasing and Payables, NAPP, and the Association for Work Process Improvement, or TAWPI. Now, I did not know that it was a merger of that many organizations. I knew that it replaced IAPP. I just didn't know that it included all those organizations as well. Now, it is an AP organization known for the CAP and the CAPA certifications. And they do like the AP teams, or their AP teams, to have a little themed fun every year. Last year's theme was the light bulb, and they suggested gift items such as the light bulb thank you keychain, the light bulb chocolate, the light bulb light up cup. And they also had suggested ways to celebrate with a team that was working from home. And so their AP recognition weeks are typically held the beginning of October every year. They have not published a 2021 date. So I said there was one that had not published it, and this is one. But last year, with all that light up and chocolate going everywhere, their last year, the week was October 5th through the 9th of 2020. And they do have a page dedicated to AP Recognition Week. Right now, it talks about what they did in 2020. But again, this organization loves their themes for the week, and they do come up with some pretty creative suggestions for gift items for your employees to recognize your employees. So I hope this actually was good information for you. I hope it also reduced some of the confusion, because I know when I first got into AP and we started celebrating AP weeks, we got a little confused with all the different or with the multiple different organizations having AP recognition or AP appreciation weeks. But I think I have it straight now, and I hope you guys found this valuable, and you will have fun with your teams by participating in at least one, or why not all three, especially since this year you've got enough time in between with the one coming up in May, the other one coming up in September, and then the next one coming up in October. So you may have enough time to spread out to celebrate all three. So have fun with your teams. So thanks, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the 134th episode of the Putting the AP in Happy podcast, where accounts payable teams are empowered to protect the vendor master file from fraud. Now, don't forget to check the show notes for the links mentioned in the podcast. If you enjoyed this episode, consider subscribing and writing a review of my podcast on the platform that you use to listen. Stay happy.